Can code be misused? Well, that's an interesting question. If there is a question of law, may not be, but if there is a question of fact, most of the time, one of the parties is very well aware that it is not in the right side of law. Even then, that particular party keeps spending money and time for that particular case, and who is going to bear the cost of the other party? Hey guys, welcome to my legal classes. This is Ganesh Pujari, and in my today's class, we are going to break that question exactly. Now, where is this covered? This is covered in the part 1 of CPC, which is all about suits in general, covering from section 9 to 35B. Now, I am going to focus on section 35U, 35UA, 35UB and order 20A. I have put a beautiful chart which gives a beautiful idea about these four things, which is in my next slide. And why are we wasting time? Let's get into the next slide. As I said, there are three important sections and one important order that we need to cover. Cause for what? The first section that we are going to cover is section 35U, which discusses about general provisions. Then we have section 35UA, which is all about compensatory for being false or vexatious. And then we have section 35UB, which discusses about cause for causing delay. And then we are discussing order 20A, which is all about miscellaneous cost. Basically, there are three types of cost: compensatory for being false or vexatious, and then we have cost for causing delay, and then there are some miscellaneous cost. Now, we need to understand them in detail. So let's start the discussion with section 35. The first and foremost thing that you need to remember is the cost of an incident to all suits shall be in the discretion of the court. It is discretion of the court, so that is one of the most important aspects that you need to remember. And court has complete power to determine who has to pay the cost and from which property that cost can be recovered, or to what extent such cost to be paid, and how exactly that to be paid, or the necessary direction for the purpose required. All these will be decided by the court. While the court has all discretion to decide the cost, court also need to keep in mind few of the important conditions, like if court cannot handle that particular suit, if that is not coming into the jurisdiction of the court, then court cannot put any kind of cost, and court has to always observe the provisions of law for that particular timeline, and then there will be some conditions or limitation to the cost that need to be observed. That is very, very important. And whenever court decides any kind of cost, it need to state the reasons in writing, or it needs to be recorded in writing. That is one of the important aspects that we need to remember. On the face, when you read this particular section, you might feel that these kind of sections are ensuring that justice is prevailed. However, once you come in to know the maximum amount that can be put as cost, which is discussed under section 35UA, you will realize that this section is not very effective. That is why in the case law of Ashok Kumar versus Ram Kumar, the Supreme Court observed that the present system of levying meager cost in civil matters is wholly unsatisfactory and does not act as a deterrent to luxury litigation. More realistic approach relating to cost is the need of the hour. If Supreme Court is observing so, then let us also try understand what is that maximum ceiling in my next slide. Section 35UA discusses about compensatory cost in respect of false or vexatious claims or defenses. Now, it can be from both the parties, and this section can be applied in suits and proceedings, but cannot be applied in any appeal or revision. Now, if there are any false or vexatious claims or defense by any of the party, in that case, court can cover the cost for same, and it can also disallow, abandon or withdraw the whole part of it. That is what discussed under section 35UA. The next important aspect that is discussed under this particular section is maximum amount that can be recovered as cost. Now, the maximum amount here mentioned is ₹3,000, and you have to decide whether 3,000 is a good amount for today or not. Here, one important provision that you need to remember is High Court may limit the amount or class of courts to award as cost under this particular section. That is one another provision you need to remember. One of the other important aspect which is discussed under 35UA3 is the other liabilities. By paying cost, no person will get exempted from any criminal liability. Imagine there is a civil liability and criminal liability, and a person is made to pay cost for being false or vexatious, and he is paying that particular cost. Now, by paying that particular cost, he will not exempted from any criminal liability which is involved in that particular case. That is one of the most important aspects you need to remember. So, as far as section 35A is concerned, all that you need to remember is, if anybody is making false or vexatious claims, it may be from the claim side or it may be from defense side. So, it can be false or vexatious defense also. If that is happening, in that case, court has the power to collect the cost from the other party which is making such false or vexatious claims or defense, a maximum of ₹3,000. That is all you need to remember when it comes to 35A. The next section, that is 35B, discusses all about cost for causing delay. There are two important ways of causing delay. The first being, in every case, there will be step-to-step action that both the parties have to take, and if any party is failing to take particular step required to take on that particular date, then that is causing delay. Or if a party is unnecessarily taking adjournment, in that case also that is causing delay. In both the cases, court can recover the cost for such delay, which is what discussed under 35B. If you give only power to the court to put cost, that is not sufficient. Court should also have the power to ensure that such costs are paid. Now, how to ensure that? There are two other sub-clauses which gives the power to the court that till the time such cost is paid, the court can stop both the plaintiff and defendant. Whoever has to pay the cost should be paid. Only after that they can take their next step. That is what the power lies with the court, and that way it ensures that such costs are paid in time. The last part that we are discussing under this particular provision is Order 20A. Now, Order 20A covers 5 important types of cost which I am naming as miscellaneous cost, and they can be recovered by court if they are going along with Section 35, 35A and 35B. Now, there are notices given which are required by law and may not be required by law also, and those costs spent towards those notices can be recovered, and the cost spent towards typing, writing, printing, pleading charges can also be recovered, and all those costs spent towards inspecting the records can also be recovered, and the cost spent towards obtaining the copies of decree of judgment in case of appeal is filed can also be recovered, and finally, the cost spent towards producing the witness may be summoned or may not be summoned. If they are going along with Section 35, 35A and 35B, those costs can also be recovered by the court. With that, I am concluding this particular session. There is one other important order, which is Order 25, which is discussing about security of cost, but that topic is not completely aligned with this particular topic, so I am handling it separately. Thank you so much if you have already subscribed my channel. If you are yet to subscribe my channel, this is your time to subscribe my channel. Please like, share and comment my videos. All the very best for whatsoever purpose you are watching me, and thanks again.